bigger thing.
Security has been beefed up in Mogadishu as Somalia prepares to conduct its first quote-unquote democratic presidential election since the ouster of Siad Barre in the early 1990s. Barre, beg your pardon. Our reporter in Mogadishu, Stanley Mbishu, now gives us a snippet of some of the arrangements that have been put in place to secure the ongoing elections expected to end on the 30th of this month.
Due to the ongoing elections for representatives of the lower house in Somalia, Amisom and other supporting partners have suspended some of their operations in some areas. They now want to support and maintain public order during elections at the polling and collating centers.
The Amisom sector commanders and the headquarters, plus the Somali National Army headquarters and his regional commanders are meeting, and now we are concluded. We agreed to do something against Al-Shabaab. We plan it, we are going to plan, and then we come together and we will take a common operation, fighting side by side against Al-Shabaab.
Our security plan is drawn in such a way that it's a joint security plan together with the not only the Somali police forces, but we have brought all other forces within the with the Somalia to ensure that we protect these elections. The outer ring is handled by our Amisom military, then the second ring by the Somali SNA and the NISA. Then the inner ring is specifically for the police.
The Amisom Deputy Police Commissioner Christine Alaro has assured all delegates of security in all polling stations across Somalia, as some women delegates have cited intimidation not to participate in the voting process.
We've at least had such a case reported where some delegates, some candidates say they have not been allowed to vote. They have been told to stand down. So those are some of the things, but they are beyond, of course, those are beyond the police. We send it to the respective authorities.
It's a challenging, like in many other African countries. The women are very active in every aspect of society, but then when it comes to political participation and it's clan involved, it's very challenging. I think you can relay from your countries as well. It's not something new to Somalia, but we are working very hard to make sure that that goal is achieved.
More stringent measures are being put in place to handle any impending threat. The upper house, which is composed of 54 representatives, has 53 seats already filled in, as Somaliland is yet to stamp their last lot. The lower house elections are still underway, with over 100 seats already filled. Stanley Mbichu, KTN News, Mogadishu, Somalia.
Right, and we want to cross over to Mogadishu and link up with our Stanley Mbishu, who has been following these elections for us. Stanley, good afternoon to you. So ahead of this November 30th election, we have seen it being postponed in the past. Does it now look like the 30th date will actually hold? It's 5 days away. Is there likely to be an issue arising that would cause that date to change once again?
Well, Sophia, good evening. There's going to be a little bit of expected delays owing to the fact that currently, as we speak, the latest updates that we have is that the upper house and the lower house across all states in Somalia, 33 women have been elected in and 151 men have been elected in, and the number has to shoot up to 275, with expected 30% of women seats and the rest being taken by women. Now, the only states that have concluded the upper elections is Hirshabelle, Galmagut, Jubaland, Puntland, and Southwest State. However, the states of Banadir and Somaliland are yet to start any election, either from the upper house or the lower house. Banadir is the state where we are right now in Mogadishu here in Somalia, and the reason why they have not kick-started their election is because, one, the final elections will be held here to elect the president on the 30th of this month. And in the state of Somaliland, negotiations are still underway to see how they can bring in their vote so that they can elect a Somalia president. Remember, Somaliland is a country on its own and Somalia is a different country. They are trying to negotiate. However, I've received information, I've got clarifications that in Somaliland there are people who are up for the elections and there are those who are not up for the elections. So there are negotiations, as we speak, there are negotiations going on so that they can come on board and do their elections. Sophia.
Right, Stanley, and are there any clear front runners in this presidential election? Are there those that already many can tell have a likely and higher chance of winning?
Kindly repeat that question again, Sophia.
Do we have any front runners in the presidential election, those that are seen as the likeliest to win, perhaps?
All right, Sophia, we have not yet been given any names of the presidential candidates who are contesting, and we don't know so far who is most likely to take over Somalia. But what I can confirm as at now is that we have over 16 candidates interested in the presidency here in Somalia. But the most determinant factor, the key factor here in Somalia, Sophia, is 135 clan members. Clans are much widely considered here in Somalia to determine who is going to elect where, who. Because the clans decide who the people who are going to elect the MPs and the senators, both at the lower house and the upper house. Then the lower house and the upper house will then elect the president. But so far, we've tried, our efforts turned out futile. We tried to consider whether we could get someone that we could talk to about the likelihood of who could be the flag bearer for Somalia as a president. But unfortunately, their cases of security are very key, and disclosing information on who is contesting and who is not has come up with a little bit of hitches owing to the security. And as I had already earlier mentioned in earlier today morning, when we arrived in Somalia, we had off the record information given to us that there were a few assassinations of some elders who one elder was assassinated for being part or trying to take part in this electoral process. However, Sophia, this electoral process is very key to Somalia because it is a process. It's called an electoral process because it is paving way for Somalia to have a one-man, one-vote process where the public is involved in voting here in Somalia. As at now, as we speak, the public do not vote in Somalia, except they are represented by 275 members of both upper and lower houses who will in tandem elect the president for Somalia. Sophia.
Thank you so much, Stanley Mbishu in Mogadishu, for us with that update on the upcoming election in Somalia, which we'll be keeping an eye on and bringing you all the updates as we get them. And you've heard from Stanley there, it's just a couple of people that will be deciding who the next president of Somalia will be, an electoral college type of system, which we saw in the United States determining Donald Trump.